Hi, I am Dr. Wasim Sheikh. Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we will discuss about different types of research articles. So, let us begin. So, let us first list what are the different types of research articles. So, the first one is the letters or rapid or short communication. Then, the second one is review paper. Third one is full length article, and fourth one is micro articles or data articles. So let us see individually what are these four types of research articles and how do they look like. So the first one is letter or short communication. So letters are mainly intended for quick and faster communication. They are of a very short length. They are of mostly 3 to 4 pages, not more than that, and they are the original advances in the area. So when people write letters or short communication is basically when they want to be the first person to talk about that particular research. So you can imagine there are 2-3 different researchers who are working on the same topic, and then one researcher, they got a significant output or results and they don't have time to write the full length article. So what they generally do is they write a letter or short communication, basically 2-3 pages, and they just try to put up their work and their word that, you know, we are the first one who are talking about this thing, this research work, so we are the pioneer in that field and so on. So that is the intention of writing letters or short communication. This is an example of letters or short communication. So the first thing which we can see here, this letter has only 4 pages. So that is the main thing when we look into letters or short communication, that the pages are very less as compared to the normal full length article. In any full length article you will see that the pages are around 10 to 15 because it has all the details of the research work which you are doing. So let us scan through and see how the letters or short communication look like. So most of the information is almost same as a full length article, like you have the name, you have the author's name, the department, then of course you need to have the abstract, then you will have the introduction section, experimental details and all these things. So all these things are there, of course, but the only thing which we know that this is a rapid communication. The researcher, they want to show that they are the first one in this particular field, so they want to put out the paper as soon as possible, and in that they are making the paper as short as possible with the lot of information which they can portray about their research. So here, as soon as we scroll down, some images are there, some figures are there, then immediately at 4th page you have the conclusion, then acknowledgement. As I said, we need to have some acknowledgement of from where we are doing the research, what grants we are getting, maybe the name of the college or university, and so on and so forth. And or very less references are there because it is a very short communication, only 9 references are there. And you can see this is a very good example of a letter. So I hope you understood how the letters look like.
So the next one is the review paper. So review paper is mainly that you are summarizing someone else's work, and mainly review papers are invited paper. You cannot write a review paper on your own. So generally when you try to publish a review paper, the editors of the journal, they ask you how much knowledge or how much experience do you have in this particular field. So it is expected that unless you have a very significant and vast experience in that particular field, you can't write a review paper on that topic. It is generally assumed. So review papers are mainly invited, but sometimes some journal do accept the review paper of new researchers, and they also accept the papers, and that depends on journal to journal. But a very good journal, very top journal, they will not accept your paper unless you are pioneer in that field and you can't write a review paper. The review paper is nothing but you are summarizing all the different types of research work that have come up earlier. You are not introducing any new idea in a review paper, and then you are summarizing maybe what people have done in the past 10 years, 20 years, or you know, maybe 5 years. That depends on how you are writing the review paper or how someone invites you to write a review paper.
This is an example of a review paper. So review paper, as we have discussed, it consists of a review of the topic which we want to select and do a review on. So here this is a paper
and immediately when you read the title of the paper, a review is mentioned. So immediately you come to know that this is a review, and in fact this journal is a renewable and sustainable energy review. So the journal itself consists all the review paper. And here one more important thing which I want to tell you, that this review paper is very lengthy and it has around 24 pages. So as I said, you know, it is generally the review paper are very lengthy, and now you can see that they are talking about some research work which is done earlier and so on and so forth. So it is a very lengthy paper, and I'll show you the amount of references which they have. So we'll just scroll down and see, it has some images and graphs. Of course it goes on and lot of different type of topics they have covered, different headings are there, and I'll just try to show you that it has so many references. So unless you have so many references, you are a pioneer in the field and you can do the review. And see here, I'll scroll down and then you'll see that they have 323 papers. So you can imagine it, they have read 323 paper and they have done the review of that. So and as I said, you know, review paper are mostly invited paper. You can't yourself do a review. Maybe sometimes they'll accept it, but most of the time, unless you are a big shot in that field, you know a lot of things, you have done the work for 15-20 years, you can't do a review paper.
The third one is full length article. In a full length article, you have very significant data which you are trying to publish. It contains a lot of details and developments and outcome, and it is the research work which you are doing maybe for a few years or a few months, and then you are trying to publish that particular data in terms of a full length article. It has very detailed information, all the different things which are there, which I have discussed in an earlier video, how to structure such type of articles and so on. So it will have a lot of information, a lot of research work which you have done, a lot of different responses and output, and it is generally around 12 to 15 pages or 10 pages, depending again on the journal. Each and every journal, they have their own requirement, they have their limitation in terms of words and pages, and then it is up to the journal where you are submitting the manuscript, and that is how you see it is a full length article.
This is an example of a full length article. So we have discussed that full length article consists lot of detailed information, and here you can see that this is the title of the paper. Of course this is my paper and I am the first author, and even I am the corresponding author, and it has the abstract and what is the date, and as we discussed there are some keywords which we need to talk about and which we need to submit to the journal. Then we have the introduction section, and generally it is around 15-20 pages depending on the journal, again depending on the journal, and there are some requirements for some words, sometimes there are some requirements in terms of, you know, the amount of pages you can have in that particular paper and so on. So this is a full length article where we need to describe each and everything in detail. So like the drill bits, the machines, the you know, the microscopes which you are using, and then you know how you conducted the experiment, how you took the data, and all this information you need to put in complete detail. Then lot of images. So this is the result and discussion section. You need to talk about what are your findings, and then in the discussion section you need to talk about you need to explain your findings and so on. So all that information will be there, and then you are having a full length research article. So this is a full length research article, and then finally you may have some few references and all that, and you are trying to put up the conclusion, and it is very detailed paper. So a lot of images are also there, and then you need to compare your work with earlier work, and then you need to say what are the differences you are having and so on. So and then you need to acknowledge, as I said, this is an optional part where you need to acknowledge where you have conducted the experiment and so on. And then references are there, you need to talk about the references, as I said, because we need to always cite some papers which we have read about the same topics and so on. So I have around 17 references, so I'm not putting a laundry list, as I've discussed in my videos earlier, that you don't have to have hundreds of references, even 17-20 references are fine, but these should be very relevant. That is what the main aim is.
The fourth one and the last one is a micro article or a data article. So in this article, you are only publishing the data. Okay, nothing else, no other information is there. You are only putting up the data. So the format of such articles are such that you are only publishing the research output. And the output can be in terms of data, it can be in terms of software, it can be in terms of the method which you have, it can be in terms of videos and so on and so forth. So basically, you can imagine that you only have the data which you are presenting in the micro article and nothing, no more information is there. A few lines or a few paragraphs are there which are talking about the data, but mainly it is only a data article.
So as soon as you open the data article, there itself it is written that it is a data article. And as I said, in the data article, you will only have the information about the data and some text and theory and some references here and there. So this paper is talking about the data of copper level in the blood of the patient. So it is only providing that data. It has all the information like, you know, authors, then their affiliation, then most of this information is there. There is some abstract is also there, very short abstract is there. Then as soon as the paper starts, it gives the information about the data, what data they are trying to put up in this data article. Then some short information about what experimental methods, design and materials they are having. And as soon as it is done, it is only 4 pages, and on the third page you find the information related to the data. So that data is there, and then finally they are acknowledging, and then it is done. So it is only having the data and around 5 references they have cited and so on. So this is an example of a micro article or a data article.
So I hope after watching this video you know what type of article you want to publish when you are doing a research work, whether you want to publish a review paper, whether you want to publish a full length paper or a data article, or you are a pioneer, you are trying to publish the first article in that particular field and you are trying to publish a letter or a short communication. So thanks for watching this video. I hope this video helps you to categorize what type of paper you want to publish. Thanks for watching. All the best.